We're told that Penny wrote a survey with open-ended and multiple-choice questions. The diagram shows the ratio of the question types. So what it shows us is that for every 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 open-ended questions, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 multiple-choice questions. And let's be clear, this is showing the ratio of open-ended questions to multiple-choice questions. It's not telling us exactly how many of each type of question we have. We just know for every 5 open-ended, there are 4 multiple-choice, or for every 4 multiple-choice, there are 5 open-ended. The table shows some numbers of multiple-choice questions and total questions that could be on Penny's survey. Based on the ratio, complete the missing values in the table. So like always, pause this video and see if you can have a go at this on your own before we work through it together. All right, so some of you might not have realized that it says total questions here. It does not say multiple choice questions and open-ended questions. So one way to tackle this is to think about, well, what is going to be the ratio between multiple choice questions and total questions? So let's think, if we were to create another bar for total questions that showed the ratio, for every 5 open-ended questions, you'll have 4 multiple choice questions, and you would have 9 total questions. So it would look like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. I'm just adding these two together. So we could say that the ratio of multiple choice to total questions is going to be 4 to 9. For every 4 multiple choice questions, you're going to have 9 total questions. So in this first row, we have 8 multiple choice questions. So that's 2 sets of 4. So we're going to have 2 sets of 9 total questions. That still is the same ratio. 8 is to 18 as 4 is to 9. And now in the second row, they give us the actual number of total questions. Well, that is 9 goes into 45 5 times. That's 5 sets of 9. So you're going to have 5 sets of 4 multiple choice questions. So 5 times 4 is 20. And we're done.